Hello, so I'll speak a little bit about the game, some of the most asked questions, a little tutorial, and also a lot of tips. Now, the most important thing to know is that this game is an open world, more or less open world, survival and crafting. Now, what most people don't really understand is that this is a game where you have to navigate the ship. So, if you're starting out new, you definitely need to build the two things that help you navigate, and that is the wind-up engine and also the weather vane. So, I don't think it really tells you in the tutorial, but this is easy to operate. You just, you know, use it, start it, left, right. But this here is the most important thing that will help you navigate. As you can see, it points you to the north, west, east, and south. So, the game is kind of based on biomes. If you reach a new biome, you can actually repeat the encounters over and over if we head west. So, going to the west, if you see the events that are that color or golden or something like that, that means you can repeat the encounters. If you go north, you'll actually leave the biome. So I suggest you stay in farm in all of the biomes a few times because you'll need a lot of resources. So always head west if you need resources and then head north if you want to advance the story and the biomes because some of them will actually be a lot different and the loot is different as well. Now, another very important thing is you need to build a sleeping bag over here because we have a day and night cycle. And the day and night cycle is actually pretty rough, meaning in the night you will not be able to loot. And night is also better for traveling because you'll see the... Let me see. You'll see the points of interest a lot easier. Also probably the wind as well because that's the wind. That's the direction of the wind and the strength of it. So yeah, the rooster will kind of show you where the wind is, the direction of the wind, but you should always follow the directions of the cardinal points. Now, this is over here. Grindstone. This will be for later, but it's over here. Another very important aspect of the game is that food and water are very hard to find in the beginning, so that's why you have to repeat the maps. I spent about 4 hours in the first map, and I just farmed encounters over and over by heading west, or just following the points. And then when I started heading north, I came into this biome. And here we are. Now, if you're asking what's the most important building, oh, by the way, never extend your ship beyond this length, because if you make this a little bigger, you'll not be able to land in the middle of towns or very close to the, you know, searching areas. I know it sounds a little weird, but for example, if this was a little bigger and I had landed on top of the sunflowers, that would have not been a problem. But if you land on top of a house, that means you have to teleport back up. But if the seeker is active, that means you have to wait until the seeker disappears. Otherwise, you will not be able to leave that area. And that will probably drain your hunger in your first alert. So try to make it as small as possible using my design or whatever you want. And then actually make a few levels and go up. Because you can also go up. You're not only limited to this, you can go up. By just, you know, building the ramps, the stairs, the door frames, and all of that other cool stuff. Because remember, you have a lot of options, even the trapdoors. So try to make the most of your space like I did over here. Basically, there are 3 crafting stations, 2 big chests in two tiles only. In the beginning, you have to craft all of the... Well, not all of them, but the item crafting is a little simple. In the beginning, you'll have to craft this for the wooden axe or the stone axes, because you'll need a lot of them to gather a lot of wood. But this is probably your most important resource in the beginning besides food and water. And as you can see, this is a tier. It's items will stack, and this is also inventory space. Might as well put that there or there. We'll leave that over there. Usually I have a few tools lying around, so I have spares. Now this is the stone pickaxe. This is what you use to mine iron and coal. Toolkits, well, they are needed to craft other stuff. I won't go into too much detail about each of them, but bandages are very important, and fiber and alcohol, because you need to heal if the seeker catches you. Fiber is gained from cactuses, and we have a lot of that, so don't worry too much about it. Now, as you can see, I have the big wooden chest over here. We also have the bobbleheads, and here is some of the more unique crafting items, and by unique, I mean you'll only need them a few times. The braziers, the buckets, a little bit of stone, the toolkits. And now let's go over here to the second tier of basically crafting, which you can only make in this area. I mean, you can also make the artificer, but you need the glass, and glass is a little harder to get. Because you need a shovel, and the shovel you can only make in the second area, so where do you find an anvil? Well, I found my anvil over here. This is the first encounter of the second biome, the desert. The anvil was right here, so probably if you find a place which already has an anvil, you have the bigger chance to find one. Anvil was over here. But I don't see any brazers around here. So it will be a little weird. You have to stock up on the first map on all the materials you find. So definitely farm one ore in the first biome and then come to this one if you feel ready. Now the second crafting bench is a little harder to make because you'll need a lot of iron, which is the blacksmith. As you can see, you need the anvil, brazier, toolkit, leather and so on. So definitely don't leave the first map without having all of these things except the anvil. And here you can make the nails. You can also make braziers, you can also make crucibles, you can also make the alcohol burner and also the tap for the cactus, which you can take water. And the tools, this is the shovel. So the shovel is a very interesting item because without it you can't gather the sand or anything else. Usually I keep my tools in the second one. And let me show you how it looks like when you have to gather dirt or sand. So there will be these piles on the ground like this, and this is dirt, but this is kind of like... You need to drink. Okay, we'll drink. Water you can get from the water skins and also wells. So, yeah, you can also take the water with the bucket and bring it to your little base. And also search the toilets for items. Sometimes they have items in them, or even anvils, as some people said. Now, for the food, you can always eat the cans or get a crafting station to pick up to cook the food. You can also carry them around with you or eat them. Okay, shut up, you'll be fed. That's I think about 20% more food or something like that. Two cans are enough to kind of fully quench your hunger. Or satiate your thirst if you want to speak in good English. Proper English. And with the bucket, you will put the water in the trough over here. And you can actually drink it, or you can of course use your canteen. And then fill it. But to be honest, if you drink from the trough, I don't know, there's not a very efficient way to calculate this, only by measuring the liquid inside. So let's eat this as well. And that's almost full food. And we'll also leave one more over there. Of course, you have to put a lot of fuel, meaning wood and coal. So all of this is run by wood or coal, so that's why you need a lot of it. In the beginning, it doesn't seem like you need a lot, but oh, trust me, a little later on, you'll need a lot. Also, fertilizer and the dirt to start planting, but for the planting, you need seeds, and seeds and plants are actually a very new update, and they don't really work as intended, so don't worry about them for right now. Anyway, it's a lot more advanced than people think. So when exploring, you definitely want to do it during the day. And also you want to be using a torch if you are inside, because that sometimes the items will be something like over here or under the bed or under the chair. Very sneaky people. Also turn on the light. And search every corner, because even though you are very thorough, sometimes you'll miss something. Like something could be over there. Something could be over the logs. I don't think that they can spawn on the houses. But oh! So there it was. Okay, I found the little guy. I think each location has a bobblehead, so before you move to the next area of location, try to find all of them. Sneaky developers. So there are not many locations and the game is not really done and there are a lot of things to do, but this is kind of like the state of the game. Also, let's go to the cactus and use the tap. This is very, very, very important to be very well organized, otherwise you'll have a lot of problems with the late game. Or even the first part of the game, because you'll forget where your stuff is, you'll forget how it is used. I mean, the developers really should add a craft from all sources option or something like that, like in Graveyard Keeper. So you don't need to check all your chests, you can just craft with whatever you have. And also, the golden ones are required to get higher tier resources or something like that. We'll talk more about that later. But now let's have a drink with the cactus. Actually, let's grab a bucket. I'm not sure if you can take water from the cactus. But we want to be prepared for everything. And this is basically the hardest part of the game, learning all of this and crafting your ship to be efficient like that. And then just going up and planting and whatever you want. Bucket? Well, that's interesting. Okay, let's go to the second one. As you can see, you have to be very, very careful. It's kind of hard to collect the water from the cactus, but if you have, let's say, two canteens and you collect water from cactuses here and now, plus with the water from the wells, you'll have basically no problem surviving in the desert. Now, be careful, because that will actually spill out all the water. Very weird system, to be honest. And looks like the leaves fall when you take all the water. Okay, now, if you jump, if you do anything crazy like that, if you run, you'll actually spill all the water from the bucket. So go gently back to your ship. Deposit the water. Yeah, Walking Simulator 101. But believe me, this game is worth it, but you should also be careful not to buy the game at a full price, because the updates it had in the last year are not very good. And they need to add a lot more stuff, including new enemies. Also, this is why I put the trowel kind of close, okay, wrong way, kind of close to the edge. So you don't have to jump to deposit the water. Okay, that was an adventure on itself. Now, some other advanced stuff will be when you have to make more ignits. So you can also put the charcoal over here if you really want it. Now, I'm not sure how you do it, but sometimes you'll find charcoal in the burners over there. That might be the leftover fire you don't use or something like that, I'm not sure, but be careful to check for charcoal or coal when you visit something that has a brazier like that. As for the sand, well, like I said, you have to use the shovel. And if you want to go into the more advanced stuff, well, that fissure and other stuff, I'll cover that in other episodes. And that's enough for now. By the way, the resource storage, you don't want to really build all of them, because you are better off storing everything in the chest. Well, except for the rope. To be honest, the rope, you really need one. Because you need sometimes one rope or two ropes, and you can just put them very easy like that, and it's quite funny to see them going like that. It's like throwing a circle in a hoop. Otherwise, I tried to play with the other resource containers, but they're not really worth it. For example, the small resource ball for the nail, not really worth it. The bandages, well, again, it kind of makes things easier on you, because look at this. You can just put every bandage in there and take only 5, or as many as you need. So that's why it's there, to kind of speed up the processing time. So I can just drink water from the trough, eat the cooked food, and then go into the next adventure, and then just deposit everything here. Okay, it's time for me to end the video, because it's almost night time. As a little hint, okay, let's call the seeker, because I want you to see it. And also kind of like the night time. You should never fight the seeker or run away from the seeker during the night time. They usually can spawn from those holes, but sometimes they surprise you. Also, see, this is what I meant by the secret stuff. It can be almost anywhere. Even in baskets, and even that one is a kind of like more secret container. Now I'm just waiting for the seeker to chase us a little bit, so I can show you kind of how to approach the seeker. You should never, I mean, you kind of have to chase him, because he can't really change levels that well, meaning he can't jump this little fence. So if you go to the high ground and kind of disorient him, you'll never have any problems. By the way, he's much, much faster than you, so don't try to chase him. Don't try to run away from him, because you will not be faster than him. Nope. Are you hiding from me? Oh, Oh, and he really scares me when he goes underground like that. So if you go on your ship, you'll basically be golden. Or you can, you don't have to go up and down. You just have to be in the middle of the ship, and that's about it. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.